Hello!
And welcome to Uniti Update, episode 12. My name is Isaac, this is Albin, and we're following the epic journey of electric city car startup Uniti Sweden.
In this episode, we're checking out how we've CNC'd out the exterior design concept in scale 1-to-1 and our business trip to Israel.
Cool, let's watch that.
Okay, so that's our new intro animation. It's pretty cool. So Mona, our creative director, and Kevin, our motion graphics designer, have made that. And we're trying to get a new look and feel of the whole Uniti update.
So now we want to show you the roundup, which is a nice part of this new concept, where we show you short clips of everything that's been going on in the last few weeks at Uniti.
In the last few weeks, we received our car computer, the NVIDIA Drive PX2.
It's a pretty impressive platform. It's as powerful as 150 MacBook Pros, and it's going to be used to test our different AI systems, and it has the possibility to take sensor input from LiDARs, radars, and multiple cameras,
and then create a virtual map that you can use to build autonomous systems for cars. So it's one of the world's most powerful car computers.
Pretty cool stuff.
And furthermore, we've done resin injection molding to do some prototyping of certain parts of the car.
Resin is a very good material when you want to create prototypes, and it can be clear or colored. And this is a test rig to try out possible iterations of the backlights and the front lights of the vehicle. And what you see here is the arrival of the putty dispenser, or also known as a gunk machine. And this is used for when you want to try out the design, for example. One way is to machine out the entire design very finely, but this takes a lot of time for the machine. So an easier and more effective way to do it is to machine out a rougher shape and then cover it with this putty and then work with the putty instead.
And we've also had a visit from a man named Mark Fusco, who has 25 years in production engineering and advanced manufacturing. He's been working in Australia, the US, and Europe, and he's going to help us make sure our production is lean and effective.
We're looking at how to assemble a Uniti vehicle in the best way and opportunities for automation in that assembly process so that we can make it simpler and better quality.
Furthermore, we've been working with the flat carbon fiber chassis. This is a test platform that we want to use to try out the different suspension systems and also the powering and the batteries of the car. In production, the chassis would look a lot different, but the chassis you see here is more for ourselves to try out the different measurements and the system of the car.
Lewis has also held a speech in London.
I'm going to speak at that building down there for Siemens Digital Cities.
And you can check it out in the description below. We've also been to a transportation event in Sochi, Russia, where Gabriella and Johan presented Uniti and did some networking to see what the Russian market looks like and how we can develop that.
Now, speaking of travel, I want to hear more about your trip to Israel.
Yeah, so a few weeks back, we went to Israel to check out some business developments and eventual partners that we might have for the company.
Cool, let's watch.
Innoviz. Okay, I just have to stop this there, because you might recognize this guy. He's from Australia, and his name is Michael Molitor.
So if you remember from episode 10, when we were in Australia.
Anyone back there in Sweden?
Well, he helped us out there, and now he's become part of the team. And Michael has a pretty impressive background. He has a PhD from Cambridge. He's a postdoc fellow at Harvard. He has been a professor at California and Columbia University. He's the former global leader of climate change services at PwC.
So in other words, he spent his whole life trying to change this world into the better, and he's a pretty badass guy to have on the team.
And I thought the world was gonna react and do something about climate change. It's done fuck all, right? Why? Because we're really more concerned about making money than we are about destabilizing the climate system. That's the end of the day, right? If you want to tackle climate change, it's a bit like Fight Club. Don't ever talk about climate change, right? Go back to the people who think they're actually making money with fossil fuels, right? And show them that, in fact, they're not actually making money. They're actually losing money.
Yeah, that video pretty much sums up Michael. Anyway, let's get back to Israel and what we did there. So we went to visit a lot of companies, and to name a few, we visited Mobileye, a company working with Intel, developing cameras and computer vision systems for autonomous vehicles and drive assist systems. And we also visited Innoviz, who develop a LiDAR, a system that uses lasers to measure to different objects around the car to build up a picture of the environment that can be used for autonomous features later. And Israel is quite big on cybersecurity, so we visited two companies that develop security systems for in-car use and cloud use, so that we really make sure that the whole system is secure for the driver and the car. And so those were the developments in Israel, and we'll update you on the progress with these companies and see how that develops. But when we were in Israel, what happened in Sweden?
Well, apart from the things that we've already showed you before in this episode, we've been working a lot with the exterior design. And ever since Uniti started, we've had an unconventional and new way to work with the design. And this is to be able to deliver a vehicle in such a short time. So we started with sketches, and then we went on to 3D printing of very small physical models, as well as virtual reality, where you could see the car in full size, but in virtual reality. And then we went on to larger physical models, if you remember from episode 9, when we had a design unveiling event. And those models were painted, and you had nice surfaces, but they were not full scale. And now we're at this stage where we're making full scale mockups of the exterior design. So the process goes like this. We start by machining out the different parts in the CNC. We then put these parts together into one. We then sand them and paint them so that it looks closely to what a real vehicle would look like. Now, the car that you see here is not the final design of the car. It's still being worked and approved upon, and we will give you the release date of the final exterior design concept in the near future.
So the progress in the design is really interesting, and to see how the process and the development's working. And that was all for this episode. However, in the next episode, we'll show you the developments on the interior design and some technical developments on the engineering side.
I just want to say thank you to all the wonderful engagement that we have in the comment section for the previous episodes. This is really great for us, and we love that you keep on commenting. Also, we have a new website. If you haven't already seen it, I strongly recommend that you check it out at unitysweden.com.
In the meantime, like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you next time. Fan, vi börjar bli bra på att väva mer, känns det som.
Mm.